not least, was Bridget, who was the black sheep of the family. She had a major attitude problem and kept marrying these guys who all looked like her first husband.
Gina Rush was the actress who played Bridget, for those of you who don't know.
How is Gina, by the way? Because I know, like her character, she was having a baby.
Yeah, well, she had a very healthy baby boy, and she's doing fine now. She's taken the next few months off, though.
Well, the character of Judy was introduced in last December's episode as part of a staged reading, Where Were You Last Christmas? Originally, the character was played by our next guest, your other fellow cast member, Glenn Gare.
Now I want all of you to know that Brian T. and I are not really drag queens, but we play them on TV.
Yeah.
Are you interested in playing roles as a man?
Yes, people only know me for playing Samantha on My Fairy Drag Mother. I was in her character way too much.
Well, I guess I'll let the new host of the Dream Factory answer this next question. What exactly is My Fairy Drag Mother?
I'm still trying to figure that one out myself.
Quite simply, the Judy Kunterra story was a parody on, you know, soap operas, and My Fairy Drag Mother was a parody on TV shows like, you know, Sabrina the Teenage Witch, Bewitched. The show basically was, instead of the witches having the magical powers, the drag queens had the magical powers, and since drag queens are really men, they were sorcerers who dressed up as women.
I guess this is where the audience and I are confused. Which of you is a drag queen in real life?
Well, I'm definitely not.
It does get a little complicated. In the very beginning, Brian T. wanted to be the focus of the Dream Factory. Then we came along and changed all that. It made the show a little multi-dimensional. It gave it a new little twist, and it was more unique. That's why Brian plays Bruce, a homophobe, and My Fairy Drag Mother. We all wanted to take the show to the next level, and actually, you know, Brian does look a lot like his twin sister Fantasy Anna in drag.
Who could possibly forget Fantasy? What happened to her?
Well, after she was kidnapped at Dionysia's wedding.
Ah! I'll take you places you've never been.
Oh, my!
She was taken down into the basement of the building by Flash, and there one of his thugs subjected her to listening to Hanson's Mbop 1,000 times.
That's a flashback.
Well, fortunately, some homeless guy started to complain. The police came in, busted down the door. There was this big shootout. And one of the thugs got shot in the buttocks. But don't worry, Fantasy's doing okay. She wasn't hurt or anything. She moved to Providence, Rhode Island, and she's living there really happily. As for Dionysia, nobody really knows what happened or where she's at.
What's the difference between Fantasy Anne and Dionysia?
Well, Dionysia has a better wardrobe, of course.
Eccentric.
Actually, everyone thought that Fantasy was Brian's twin cousin. But in reality, as we all learned, she was actually his twin sister. You know, Dionysia is just a drag queen.
Where is Brian T., by the way?
He's still going to be involved in producing the Dream Factory, but he's decided to have more of a behind-the-scenes role in the show. Our studio is completely reconstructed after being blown up by Laura.
I'm still real sorry about that. I don't know what came over me. Mm-hmm.
Then we all went to New York City because we were possibly going to tape the show there if the reconstruction couldn't get finished.
Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it. New York, New York. These vagabond shoes are longing to stray right through the very heart of it, New York, New York. city that doesn't sleep and find I'm king of the hill, top of the heap. These little town blues are melting away. I'll make a brand new start of it in old New York.
Where is
if
he?
I can make it there, I'll make it anywhere. It's up to you, New York.
That's when it all got really crazy and Aurora came back from the dead.
Oh, oh my!
But wasn't Aurora the cast member who died at the end of last season?
You wayward wench!
Or so we all thought. Now, this can get confusing, so listen and listen carefully. It's no secret that Aurora was a drag queen in real life. Actually, our cast member, Tom Patterson. Well, several months ago, Tom was part of a scientific experiment, and he was a clone, or he was cloned. Tom went into hiding, and his clone was on our show. So it was his clone that was at the wedding and got evaporated.
Tom, a.k.a. Aurora, is alive and well. We even produced a mini-movie about it called Behind the Scenes, The Search for Aurora.
Actually, I was the one who produced it. Aurora really did get lost in New York, though.
Well, I thought Brian T. produced it. Of course, I didn't even get to go. He didn't even ask me to be in it.
How come you get more camera time than all of us?
It's because I'm the host.
You hogged up the last season just as much.
Is Fantasy Anna a lesbian?
She likes men and women.
Excuse me, I'm the one who should be answering the questions here. I think I know more about it than the rest of you.
Don't even go there with that attitude.
Don't make me take one of Dionysia's pumps and shove it where the sun don't shine.
Coming soon, Glenn Gear in Fatal Attraction 2, as Glenn Close's cousin, Alice, as a telemarketer.
Hi, this is Alice. Would you like to buy a screwdriver? Well then, screw you!
Okay, we're going to be taking some audience questions right now. Anybody have any?
Laura, now that your character Judy Kunterra is rich, will she move to a deluxe apartment and actually have a life?
Well, actually, Judy could have handled a little bit better than she did, but she did have the foresight to invest about an eighth of the money in mutual funds. Then she went to Las Vegas and tried to make it big and blew everything.
But she's still crazy.
Mm-hmm.
What about Dorothy? Will Aunt Dorothy from My Fairy Drag Mother come back from the dead, too?
We have extended Aunt Dorothy's contract, but we have put in the stipulation she is not allowed any more of that god-awful screaming.
Oh. And she has to shave her legs.
Oh. And the chest.
This is the 80s, sweetheart. You should come back from our makeover show, okay?
I think the most important question the whole world wants answered is, why are you still on the air?
Well, that's easy. It's because everybody loves us. Yeah, we have a lot of viewers out there who have really like us, especially our number one fan, James Lyle. He has told us that he loves us, and there are lots of people out there that have come to expect quality family entertainment from us, and we're here to deliver.